It was back in August, during the dog days of the summer transfer window, when Mikel Arteta paid Edu a visit, demanding that Arsenal push to sign a new right back. The two debated over the issue, with Edu maintaining that while a right back would benefit the side, it wasn't of paramount importance. But then, after Callum Chambers' struggles during the first game of the season, as well as Hector Bellerin's demands to go out on loan, Edu finally gave in to Arteta's demands and made contact with Italian side Bologna about Takiro Tomiyasu, the 6'2 Japanese defender who, in just 3 months, Arsenal fans have completely fallen for. When Arsenal's recruitment team submitted their list of potential targets for the summer transfer window, Tomiyasu was among them. Although this deal began to develop rapidly at the very end of the window, it is understood that Arsenal representatives first declared their interest to Bologna months before they eventually signed Tomiyasu. So, without further ado, meet Arsenal's fifth and final signing of this summer window, Takiro Tomiyasu, the Japanese right-back who has been a superb and transformational signing since he joined Arsenal back in August. When it came to recruiting a right back for this summer, Arsenal were targeting a very specific type of player. While fans were calling for the likes of Max Aarons and Tariq Lamptey, Arteta and Edu were looking for an entirely different profile of player. In terms of Arsenal's system, Arteta understood that they didn't need another fullback who regularly bombed forward. With that, they have Kieran Tierney, arguably one of the best attacking fullbacks in all of England. Instead, Arsenal wanted a right-back who was comfortable in central areas, which would enable Arsenal to build out of the back in a back three. Furthermore, they were looking for a right-back who would provide more defensive solidity, as well as some aerial prowess. Essentially, they wanted a better version of what Callum Chambers provided last season. Ultimately, Tomiyasu was identified as the ideal player that Arsenal were looking for at the right-back position. During his time in Italy, the Japanese international has played as both a right-back and centre-back. Furthermore, Bologna's system was very similar to Arsenal's in the sense that the team defended in a back four, but moved to a three in possession. With his 6'2 frame, Tomiyasu also had the height and aerial presence that Arteta was looking for. However, despite all this, who knows whether or not Arsenal would have ever signed Tomiyasu if it wasn't for an incident that occurred early on in his childhood. Growing up, Tomiyasu didn't always want to be a footballer. In fact, as a youngster, Tomiyasu had dreams of being an Olympic swimmer. However, a childhood accident saw him change course completely. While running on a treadmill at his grandma's house when he was younger, he slipped, injured his jaw, and required stitches, which inevitably meant he couldn't swim for some time. This led Tomiyasu to try football instead, a decision that I doubt he ever looks back upon and regrets. As Tomiyasu grew older, his immense talent became evident. He began to rapidly rise through the ranks in the Japanese First League, and by the age of 18, he was firmly established as one of the best center backs in the league. However, Tomiyasu was always aware that he needed a club in Europe to take a chance with him, if he really wanted his footballing career to take off. In November of 2017, a public business transaction became one of the most important events of Tomiyasu's young career. By this, I mean when Belgian signed Sint-Truiden were bought by Japanese internet company DMM. Part of the ownership's plan for Sint-Truiden was to use it as a launchpad for elite Japanese talent, and Tomiyasu became the face of their project. Just a few months after the ownership took over the Belgian side, Tomiyasu made his dream move from Japan to Europe. Tomiyasu was immense in his first full season in Belgium, so good that he caught the eye of clubs in some of Europe's strongest leagues. By the summer transfer window of the next year, it was eventually Bologna, who signed Tomiyasu for a fee of 9 million euros. At the time, Sint-Truiden had fielded interest from several Premier League and Bundesliga clubs, but eventually Tomiyasu and his representatives were convinced that the Serie A was the best league for his development. Over the course of the next two seasons, Tomiyasu became a regular at Bologna. Furthermore, as his career in Europe began to blossom, so has his standing at international level. Throughout the last 10 years, Tomiyasu has represented Japan at every level, from under-13s through to the senior side. Now, he already has 27 full caps for the national team, and has become one of their most important players. While it has been hard to find flaws with Arsenal's summer business thus far, Tomiyasu has arguably been one of Arsenal's best signings. He has been the perfect solution for Arteta. Throughout the last transfer window, Arsenal's strategy has been to build for the future. And with Tomiyasu, Arsenal now have a versatile right-back who has already become a first-team regular. Loved by the entire fanbase, all I can say is thank goodness he quit swimming all those years ago. Because Takiro Tomiyasu, we love you. We truly do.